Wow, morning everybody. That looks a little bit chilly, doesn't it? Might just get it finished in time for the real bite of winter. But made quite a few steps forward yesterday. Put the latches on it, like you can see, it can all pack away. Finally got a decent coat of paint on it between the rain and the frost. So I'm hoping that when it thaws out this morning that will be okay. Gonna give the inside another lick of paint, and then I've got to work out a method of closure for the flap, but really pleased with the way it's turned out. Freezing all morning, imagine waking up in that. Wow, hi YouTube. Just give you a quick whiz around the pretty much finished rooftop tent before I put something else on the table that I've been just waiting for the U-bolt fixings to turn up. Hopefully they'll be here sort of Monday, Tuesday. I'll put it on the truck and then we can get it out and play with it. But quite pleased with how this one's turned out.
The difference with this one to the other ones that I made is I put zips in this one. I managed to find a company that do these really big heavy duty zips. These zips are 48 inches long and I've got two of them.
So the sides turned out quite nice. They're quite tight. A little bit of fiddling around to sort of get it fitted. Got the six LEDs on it, so they're all wired up and ready to rock and roll. That's what the front finally looks like. Two LEDs on this side, because this is the side that I'm going to sort of cook all my admin on, do the cooking really. But yeah, really pleased with the way it's turned out. Like I say, it's the tidiest one I've made so far.
And then I'm going to generate a little bit of space and we can get the next thing out that I've been working on. I went for this sort of bungee shock cord around it, which just sort of gathers up the canvas, just helps you pack it up. As complicated as it is, I think I'm going to have a lot of fun with this.
So this is going to be my draw system for the back of the truck. This is 25mm shuttering ply, managed to lay my hands on for pretty much nothing. Bit of carpet that came out of the same skip that the wood came out of to make the base of the rooftop tent, so that was for nothing. A bit of adhesive, bit of paint, that's about it really. That is a fridge slide on the top there. Now the runner for the fridge slide cost me £12, I think. There are two drawers that I bought that are just kind of steel boxes, but I'll get those for you. They were £10 each. So here are my drawers. They were literally just steel storage bins from a office furniture company, and I paid £10 each for these. Carpeted the tops. It's got a steel bottom, so my idea is really to sort of be able to turn the lid over, and you know, if I need a steel service to cook on or anything like that, you know, I can use that. So there's a couple of holes here that I've yet to kind of clean out that just help you open and close the thing, and I say yet to cut those out. But they're going to be my drawers. Just use some sort of upholstery adhesive just to stick it all together. The carpet's pretty dirty. What I did was I just used some carpet cleaner, some foam carpet cleaner. Did the carpets with that. Leave it for a couple of hours to dry and then hoover it up. There's a few photographs I'm going to drop in, sort of before and after or during the process of making this thing. This little unit's probably cost me about £32, I suppose, all in to make. That's going to be my kind of fridge slide, like I say. But £32 in total, so really pleased with that. But obviously the next thing that I've invested in is a fridge, and I'll just put that on the table for you. So
So this is my new vehicle base fridge. I've had to make a cover for it. It didn't come with a cover, so I've just laid my hands on a bit of fabric like I do. This was a couple of old thermal insulating bags, really, used for sort of medical services. And what I've done is chopped a couple of broken, sort of worn out ones up, stitched them together, made myself a cover for it. Really wanted a cover because I don't think it needs the sort of the extra thermal insulation. I'm not exactly driving across the Kalahari, but it's going to stop the fridge getting damaged, which I was really keen on, and it cost me nothing bar a little bit of time, you know. So it's just a cover to stop it getting knocked around and damaged in the back of the truck. Okay, so this is a Waco fridge. In truth, this is probably bottom level of all the Waco fridges. You know, they go from maybe £100. They do a range of cool boxes up to about £100, and then they do fridge boxes from about £150 up to, you know, several thousand. But this one is called a Mobi Q40, so it's a 40-litre cool box. It will run on 12 volts, and it will also run on 230, so AC/DC. What you could do with this, of course, is you can plug it in the house to cool it right down, put whatever you're going to put in it, you know, and then just unplug it from the wall, sort of thing. Take it to your truck, plug it in there, and so subsequently you've got a good cool temperature in it. But does kind of most things. So AC/DC, it's got an auto switch. As you can see, it's made of aluminium, so it's fairly sturdy. It's got these sort of fold away handles on the sides that you can just see, you know, and they're really good sort of tie down points onto the fridge slide that I've made myself. Inside I think two or three compartments. As I've said, the split lid minimizes kind of cold loss when you open it. The other great thing about this is you can stand 2 litre bottles up in it, and that's a kind of real bonus, because some of them are just that little bit too small that you wouldn't get something like that.
So what I normally do is I normally put a couple of these 2 litre bottles in our chest freezer until they're frozen, so they're just sort of solid ice. Put them in my fridge, and that's how I'd take it out. So that is in effect the cool.
I watched a film on a guy that drove across the Kalahari, and very simply he took a cool box, put a great big piece of ice in the bottom of it, kept the lid closed with maybe a heavy bag on top of it, and a block of ice across the Kalahari lasted him well in excess of 5 days, you know.
So with the bottles of ice in the cooler, what that's going to do is this cooler will cool its contents down to 22 centigrade below the ambient temperature. So here in the UK, you know, that's going to be fine. In truth, it would be a surprise if I ever had to plug this unit in. So the fridge has two settings for us, really, on the inside. You can just see it there. It has an economy and it has a maximum, so decide what you need. Really, if you're kind of, if you've got it plugged in, you're running on a trip, let's say you're doing several hundred miles, you'd just bang it on economy. If you really want to start the box off, you know, so you've literally just put it in the vehicle and plugged it in, then you want to be putting it on
so
max.
Quite like this, this flap, you know, just sort of lifts and folds out of the way. In there I've got a 13 amp plug that just plugs straight into the wall, and I've got a 12 volt lighter socket. When the cables come out of here, they've got a really nice little sort of groove just down here that they sort of go down the side and out the back.
So there are your leads and cables. The top just sort of slides across, but that just ensures that nothing gets snagged, caught up, broken, you know. So that's something else that I quite like. Like I say, two sturdy kind of tie down or carry handles. These handles are spring loaded, so that's all kind of good. But that's the little fridge unit that I've decided on, and goes on my fridge slide.
So that's how it's going to go in the vehicle, be able to pull it out, be able to give me access to it. I've got a little step on the back of the truck, so it won't be this high, and I'll be able to get in and out of it. I deliberately made the fridge slide just a little bit tight because I didn't want it sliding in and out as I was driving, really. But like I say, quite pleased with the steel drawers. I think they're going to give me a little bit more organisation. My idea is to use one for all of my tools and a little bit of recovery equipment, and then the other one for food, saucepans, you know, kind of cooking incidentals, my cooker, all that sort of stuff. So I'm going to drop in a few photographs of the process of making it. I'll get it put in the truck pretty soon, but this is going to be yet another step along the road of my kind of vehicle, my new bug out vehicle kit out. So again, you know, total cost without the fridge was about £32. Didn't think that was a lot of money. Obviously a lot of stuff is sort of reused, recycled, but I quite like the idea of being able to sort of clean stuff up and reuse it. Snow shovel, and that's about it. Like I say, you know, food, dehydrated dry food, a small cooker, and some pots and pans and utensils are going to go in there. This is tools and spare parts for the truck, two fire extinguishers, 60 LED lamp, got my Mobi Q40 fridge, got my bug out bag, my recovery kit, vehicle security items, and that's about it. That's my new drawer system for my BOV. As always, any comments, love to hear them. Back soon.